Today's video is all about bow exercises. This video is great for my beginner students, but it's also great if you've been with me for a while and maybe you need to work on maybe just getting back to the basics. You've got some tweaking to do, then this video is right for you. So I'm going to be using a bass bow, but I'll let you know when I'm doing an exercise that's specific for the violin. So let's get started. The first one I'm going to do is called the spider crawl. Now, all of these exercises that I'm doing today, I haven't created any of these myself. They all exist on YouTube already, but I wanted to make a video where they were all together and something that my students could access easily. So again, the first one is called the spider crawl. Student is going to hold the bow right in front of them like this. You're going to make sure that you have a nice bow hold. So if you're cello or bass, you're like this, violin, like this. So start with a nice bow hold. Let's get back to a bass bow hold. And so if you've never done this before, it's okay if you want to support your bow by putting your hand right underneath it. But what you really want is to not use the hand at all underneath. And what you're going to do is you're going to crawl your fingers up the stick. And then you're going to crawl back down, just like a spider. Notice that I'm trying my best not to touch the horsehair. So then maybe once you get a little bit more comfortable with that, you can take away your hand and then really get it going. It is much more difficult to go back down, but repetition is key with this exercise, and you'll really feel your fingers build some dexterity, and you'll be able to have a better tone, and you'll have a better bow hold, and it'll be stronger. You'll definitely see the benefits if you keep trying. Okay, so that was the spider crawl. The next one I have listed is called the rocket ship, and for this one I'm just going to kneel down so you can see the top of the bow. So again, I have my bow hold, and I have a nice platform, and if you see it from the side, my arm is next to my body, it's nice and relaxed. Let me start with a 90 degree, there we go. And I'm just gonna go straight up to the sky, drawing a straight line to the ceiling. Hopefully you can see that. I still have a nice bow hold, my wrist is nice and flexible, and then I bring it back down. I'm only kneeling on the ground so you can see the whole thing. You don't have to do that at home. You can still stay in your seat or standing and go straight up and straight back down. So that one's called the rocket ship. The next one I have listed, this one is more for a violin, so it's called the windshield wiper. So for violin, and yes, I know this is a bass bow, but pinky up, and nice and slow, you're going to use your fingers to bring your bow up, and then bring your bow back down. Bow goes up, bow comes down. Bow goes up, bow comes back down. Notice I'm keeping my bow hold, my thumb's nice and curved. I'm not using my wrist, I'm not going like this. I'm using my fingers, very nice and slow. And then a little bit harder version of this is called the pinky push-up. Same idea, but you're just going to use your pinky. And again, this is for violin or viola. You're just going to use a little. So I'll get a little closer so you can see that. So here's my pinky. So I'm pushing. Maybe hopefully you can see that. My pinky is bending to get it to pop out of my hand. And it's just a little pop. I'm just going, there it is. Maybe that's a better angle. Yeah, let's try that. Yeah, that's better. So it's called the pinky push-up. So for violin or viola. And that's really it. So it's like a really small, fast version of the windshield wiper. Okay, and then the last two could be for violin, viola, cello, or bass. Back to your bow hold. I'll get back to my bass bow hold. You're going to make a little bowl with your hand. Put the end screw of your bow. And you're going to stir. Notice that I'm stirring with my fingers. I'm not going like this. I'm going like this. This is challenging. This is definitely a one-on-one thing that you want to do with your students. Okay, and then a big bowl. As much space as they want to take up. There you go. I believe that's all I had listed. Yeah, those are all of my bow exercises that I use with my students. And I hope that they're helpful for you. And if you have any that you know about, please feel free to comment below. And if you have any questions or if you couldn't see any of those clearly, please let me know and I'd be happy to make another video of just that exercise. Thanks so much.